Hello everyone. On behalf of Indian National Trust for Art and Cultural Heritage INTAC and the INTAC Conservation Institutes, I extend a very warm welcome to our distinguished speaker, Dr. Suthapa Chakravarti, and everyone who has joined us for today's talk in the Conservation Insights 2020 lecture series. I'm Dr. Padma Rohila, Director ICI Delhi. Now to introduce our speaker, Dr. Suthapa Chakravarti is an MSc in Chemistry and a PhD in Science. She had earlier worked as a senior scientific officer of chemistry in the National Institute of Criminology and Forensic Science before joining the National Archives of India in 1993. She is presently the Assistant Director of Archives Preservation, National Archives of India, Delhi. She is managing the conservation program there of documentary heritage housed in the archives. She also supervises various conservation projects of the department, which included projects such as the conservation of Sanskrit and Gilgit manuscripts, Fort William collection, the rare photographs collection, etc., and also the conservation projects of Vishwabharati, Shantiniketan, West Bengal. Presently, she is looking after the conservation activities of the department and including ongoing conservation projects and quality check of all preservative materials used in the department. She's also responsible for the academic part of the training courses in the field of conservation conducted by the School of Archival Studies, National Archives of India. Today, the title for today's talk is Management of Preservation Program of Archival Heritage, Problems and Prospects. Archival materials play a critical role in the preservation of cultural heritage of the nation. Archives and records are also the tools by which the governments can make themselves accountable. Due to deterioration of archival materials by various factors, the preservation becomes absolutely necessary for the records housed in such institutions. Preservation not only helps to maintain, but also to protect archival materials from being damaged or deteriorated. A proper preservation program is necessary for protection and to increase the longevity of the archival materials. Importance of preservation program for keeping the archival heritage of India safe and in stable condition, its proper management and implementation of such programs through the National Archives of India will be discussed by the speaker today. Before I invite Dr. Suthapa, may I request all of you to please keep your microphones on mute. Please type in your questions in the chat box. We'll take those at the end of the talk. And also please do type in your name, organization name and email ID. We'd love to know who all have joined us today. Over to you, Dr. Suthapa. Thank you so much for doing the talk.
Okay, thank you, Padma Rohila ji. And good evening to everyone who has joined and who has from the other countries. Good morning to them. So my topic of discussion is management of conservation program, as Padma Rohila has said. So first thing, in my first slide, you can see the building photographs. This is the National Archives of India building. So, and this is the logo. We have completed our 125th year in 2006. And we launched this logo of National Archives of India on that year of celebration of 125th year. So we have completed 125th year. So we are in this field for preservation of archival heritage since so long. So now first thing, before this, going into the preservation program, I want to discuss say a little bit about the archival heritage. So what are that? This is the documents or records which is generated during the normal functioning by the creator. Historical material, because historians or other people or researchers, they can come, they can consult what happened in the past. So it is a very important source of documented material of our past. So without this resource, will not be able to know about what happened in the past. And it is also an information system archive. So it is one more important thing. It is the primary source of information. So it is very, very important. Whatever document, whatever archival heritage you are having, it is the primary source. The books is written and obviously all are secondary heritage. So you can see some of the pictures of our documentary heritage here. I will show you some more. So now, how many types of archives? We are talking about the archival heritage. So archival documents are housed in all the documents related to the archives. So first one is the government archives, so which is dealing with the records of the local bodies. State archives are dealing with the state governments, and central government entities are dealing with the, that is the national archives of any country. They are dealing with the records of the central government bodies. Second one is the corporate archives. That is, nowadays, most of the corporate houses, they have set up their archives. Just like Tata in India, Tata Central Archives, they are having their own archives. RBI, Reserve Bank of India, they are having also their archives there. Third one is the college and university archives. Means college and universities, they are also, they have also started setting up their own archives. Then historical societies, so which are preserving the history of the region. Religious archives, most of the individual places of worship, they have also started setting up their archives. And special collections, that is some private persons, there is the families, individuals, organizations, they are also started setting up their archives. So now what is the importance of archives? Once we have set up our archives, we'll come to know about what happens in the past, what is the origin of this document. Suppose if any corporate archives, we'll come to know, just like Tata archives, we'll come to know about the industrial development of our nation. So all the archives and the records housed there are all of permanent in nature. Whatever records are kept in the archives, suppose in National Archives of India, we are receiving records from all the government departments, ministries of government of India. What type of records? Obviously, the permanent records. And generally, records are transferred to the National Archives of India after 25 years. So there is a year, 25 years, and it, that will be available for consultation after 5 years, that is from 30 years. So these 5 years for complete preservation and documentation program, because archives is an information system. So proper documentation of all the records before consultation is very, very important. So now what are the functions of archives? Most important is the records management and record appraisal. Means whatever records we are receiving here, that are permanent record. Besides that, suppose all the departments, they are creating records every year. Earlier, only the physical records, but nowadays, along with the physical records, very less. Obviously, the percentage is very less, but they are creating physical records side by side, electronic records also. So whatever, what records is to be transferred to the National Archives of India, team from National Archives of India, they are accessing or examining the records before transfer. Then second one is the acquisition, means whatever records is to be transferred, that will be the new acquisitions or the collections of the National Archives of India. Then acquisition and the arrangement, that is the part of the documentation, means how the records will be documented and will be transferred to the consulted to the research group for consultation, because all the records are public records, that is public access is there. So we have to supply the records, and the persons are coming, they will consult the records there. Then services may access is very, very important. Whatever records are open records, that has to be supplied to our research room, maybe in the electronic form, maybe in the physical form. If the electronic form is not available, then only the physical copies are supplied. And then it is preservation. Preservation is very, very important part of archives, because without the preservation, keeping the records in a good condition or good physical conditions, usable conditions, will be very difficult, because most of the paper documents are on paper. Besides paper, some other documents on some other writing surfaces are also there, but majority of the documents are on paper. Then outreach program, that is exhibition, seminar, just to promote the archives, that people should know about the archive. This is the outreach program should also be conducted. And nowadays, most of us, we are in the digital age. So it is really important to prepare the copies of the records and also to safeguard the original records. Because physical records, paper, on handling, it may get damaged. So it is better if you have all this microfilming and digitization facility. And now mostly in all the archives in India or in other countries, they are doing the digitization work. So in National Archives of India's core activities, most important is the implementation of the Public Record Act, as we are responsible for the management of the records of Government of India. So one Government of India has enacted an act, which is the Public Record Act 1993. It is not okay. This is the Public Record Act 19. I will not go into detail of this act, but it was published in the Gazette of the India in 22nd of December 1993. And as per this act, following this Public Records Rules 1997 also done by the Government of India. So most important part is the preservation and conservation of records, which is the part of the Public Record Act also, and it is in National Archives of India's core activities also. Then servicing or supplying the records to the record creators, means maybe the agencies, means ministries, departments, and also to the research scholars and or we can say the users. Whoever wants to consult the records, whatever records are open to the public, that has to be supplied. Then digitization and microfilming of the record, that is the reformatting of the physical records. And nowadays we are in the digital age, so we will receive the electronic data also. So it is an added responsibility. Side by side physical records, we have to take care of the electronic records created by the Government of India also. So in this regard, department has already MOSCP by the DOPT department who is responsible. Then it also comes under the NAI's core activities, outreach programs, that is to create awareness about the cultural heritage of our country. So now archival collections, whatever collections we are having the custody of NAI, this category is public records, departmental records, private papers, oriental records, and cartographic records. That is different forms of the records. So what are the forms? In what form we are having the records in our custody? That is in the loose sheet, in the file format, in the bound or textual documents, photographs, posters, artworks, architectural drawings, and printed and hand-drawn maps. Besides that, in some of our private collection, we are having very less percentage of textile material also donated by some eminent personality. And this is our main building of our National Archives of India. Obviously, the picture is very small. So now you can see the different types of documents we are having in our custody. So this is from the one of the volumes from our public records. This is the cartographic records. This is one of the treaties, and it is the longest document in our custody. It is almost long, around 16 feet. This is the illustrated manuscript from our Sanskrit and Gilgit manuscript collection. This is also the illustrated manuscript. And this is the Gilgit manuscript, which is the oldest manuscript we are having in our country, these two. Besides, we are having the oriental records also. And mainly, major part we are having in this form, that is the file form, before independence also and post independence also, that is in the file form. So from there it is clear that we are having so many different types of documents, and we have to take care of all the type of documents, and whatever is needed, we have to provide the records in a good physical condition. So this is just glimpses of the holdings in our custody. We are having the continuous series of records, Government of India since 1748, continuous series of all the departments. total shell space runs into approximate 40 kilometers of linear space, which contains the records from all major ministries, their successor bodies. And what are the major ministries and departments? Home Department, External Affairs, Defense, Commerce, all these things. Human resource. Obviously, this is the post-independence records, because earlier it was only the Home Department and HRD department set up after independence. And then PMO records also. So what is the quantity? Quantity of the records is approximate 50 lakhs files, 64,000 volumes, 1.2 lakhs maps, and 3,600 bills assented to the president, 1060 treaties, and 2,400 rare manuscripts. Besides, the earliest records in our possession is the Gilgit manuscript of 16th century AD, which is on Birchbark, and we received it in 1949 or 1950. And besides that, we are having private papers of eminent personalities who contributed towards the Indian freedom fighters, freedom struggles, public life. And we are also having some institutional collections also. NEI has also acquired 7,500 microfilms rolls of private papers of Indian interest from other archival repositories across the world. And we are having Oriental records also, which is generally 1.5 lakhs to approximate estimation. Major chunk is in Persian, that is in Oriental, and other languages like Sanskrit, Gurmukhi, Odia, okay? Nine lakhs collections, including the rare books, which is the rare books, travel logs, gadgeteers, census reports, all these things. Some important collections of our gadgets are Gadget of India, 1964 onwards, we are having Calcutta Gadget, 1792 to 1863. This is the London Gadget. And this is the census of India, 1871 onwards, Imperial and District Gadgeteers, Paramilitary Debates, 1892 to 1935, that is a continuous series. Legislative Assembly Debates, 1887 to 1920. Then we are also having proscribed literature, travel accounts, and rare books of history, besides our normal collections. So now, how we are keeping the record? This is something, this is the stack areas of our heritage building, which was constructed before independence. It is 1925. And these stack areas are also of that time. It has gangways of shelf space type. And this is the, you know, medieval, as a story, we need more, as one thing is very important, archival records are ever growing. Its number will increase with the passage of time. It will never decrease, maybe in the electronic form, maybe in the physical form. So we need more space. So as part of this development programs, we have just installed a compactor system in one or two of our floors. So this is the compactor systems and this is our stock area, the very small corner, I can say. So what is the need of preservation? As you have seen, we are having the bulk, so much of bulk, so we have to take care of all the records. So we need a complete preservation program, as we have to receive the records from the records creator. Then we have to keep the records inside the stack areas properly. Then we have to supply the records to the users for consultation. And side by side for consultation, the digitization program is also going on. So preservation of the documents of enduring value, it is very, very important. So for this, what is needed? Scientific management and preservation program, without which it is not possible to keep the records, that mainly the paper records and other records on the organic media or in the electronic media in a good conditions. So preservation is an important part of archives, because these are some of the damages of the records, and most important problems is the stapler pins. It is everywhere, you can see. This is also damages if you keep it in the under sunlight or all. And this is some damages occurred by some insect at the spine area only. And these documents is completely damaged by sometimes when we receive the documents in this condition, first thing is we have to take the condition assessment of the records. So physical stability of the archival documents generally depends on the quality and type of the materials used for creation of the records. And for creation of the record, that is, I'm talking about now the physical records, we need two things. One is the writing surface, which should be of good quality. So nowadays, paper, earlier we have some documents on palm leaf and birch bark also, and some other things also. And writing and printing of handwritten records, this is the writing ink, and in case of printing media, actually conservation of printed materials is more easier compared to the handwritten record. These are of various kinds, because not only black ink, not only blue ink, there are so many types of inks are available on our records. Collections in archives are mostly on paper. And then one more added thing is management and conservation of electronic record, that is the burnt digital record, that is we are converting the physical record to the digital format, and the burnt digital record, which we are used to receive maybe within 1 or 2 years. Still, we have not received any burnt digital records, but we are having burnt digital in our custody as this program is going on. So in the paper degradation, there is something, as it is organic in nature, it will get damaged automatically. Main constituents of paper is cellulose, as you know. So it will be damaged by some physical factor, chemical factors, biological factors. So what are the factors? Paper degrades due to the various factors. There is a physical factor, that is heat, light, and humidity. Biological means various insect pests and fungus. Chemical, that is mainly the environmental, or we can say the acidity, which is very, very harmful for the papers. And disaster. So by disaster also, documents can get damaged. So this is one example of damage by the biological factors, or we can say it is a disaster also. Documents damaged by termite. Then this is the damage by some insects, and this is by mishandling. Suppose while handling the documents, if some of the pages are folded, because the paper is old paper, it's not a new paper. So sometimes you can say the paper is tear from this line, folded line. And these documents is damaged by completely water. So fungus can grow, or the pages can stack up. There are so many problems. So now what is cellulose? Why cellulose are decomposed? This is the chemical structure of cellulose. All of you must be knowing it is a polymer of glucose, and the small glucose units are joined together by the hydrogen bonding. So this is the chemical structure. So now what is the fiber structure? It is a cellulose fiber, so it is a thread-like structure. Inside this thread-like structure, it has two things. One is the macrofibril and microfibril. All are made up of cellulose chains. So this is the cellulose chain is made up. Once the cellulose is breaks down, so it started degrading the paper. So another problem of the main problem, I can say, is the acidity, because the poor quality of the material used for the creation of the records, or poor storage conditions, or use of poor quality preservative materials and storage materials used for this purpose. So paper documents can be severely damaged by the acidity, and so it's a big problem for the collection managers. Because due to acidity, documents can be completely disintegrated if we are not taking appropriate action. Because acidity causes the irreversible damage, and paper loses its physical strength. And also there is a changes in the fiber structure. This is just, I want to show you, this is not done in NAI. This is from some research paper of some scientist. So this is the alpha cellulose structure, which is a photograph taken at 300x. This is the normal cellulose structure. Suppose if it is treated with the 55% cellulose, some of the fibers are disintegrated. If it is treated with the 60% sulfuric acid, fibers disintegrated more than the this position, that is when it is treated with the 55% sulfuric acid. And when it is treated with the 65% sulfuric acid, you can say there is no fiber. So paper is completely disintegrated. So this is the what happens in the if paper is acidic in nature. Acidity actually accelerates the hydrolysis reaction rate of our documents, and it acts as a positive catalyst. So there is a decomposition of the cellulose. So now, how it look like? So what will be the effect of acidity? Because when we are conserving all the time, we are not doing the flavor analysis, we are not doing the all these things. What we are doing, we are measuring its pH and all. So suppose these documents, pH of this document is 3.5. So we can say it is very difficult to handle. This document was typed at that time, but the ink was acidic. So you, if you will minutely see, you can see the holes. And pH of this paper is below 2. So it is completely disintegrated. And this paper's pH is around 4 point something. So you can handle it a little bit with some support. And so main problem is the how to check acidity. One thing is use a good quality storage material, and obviously use a good quality material for conservation also. Whatever material we are using for storage, that is a file cover, file board, or storage boxes. And besides, we have to ensure the stable storage conditions also, that is the microclimate or on. And if there is, you can see after examination, one portion of our records or one series of our records are highly acidic in nature, that should be kept separately away from the other records. The other records should not get damaged. So now in the preservation program, what is its need? It's ensure the appropriate and timely preservation of records and make them available for the use to the user. Maybe in the electronic form or maybe in the physical form. What is the role of a preservation program? That is the overall management of the preservation of activities of that department. It comprises of some points. One is the preventive measure. That is, by taking the preventive measures, we are trying to avoid the damage happens to the records by all the factors, that is the physical, chemical, and biological. After, as you know, prevention is always better than cure. But if after taking all these measures, our records are get damaged by somehow, by insect, by fungus, or by water, or by mishandling, by any means, we have to take the remedial or curative measure. That is, we can eradicate or we can minimize the damage to the records. As with the passage of time, paper, physical strength of the paper decreases, or it loses its physical strength. So to re-strengthen the paper, the next step is the re-strengthening. When we are doing the various conservation treatment, that is we are using either tissue lamination, means tissue repair, full press, depending upon the condition of the records. And the last one is the digitization and microfilming. That is preparation of the copies of the records, that is the digital form, in the digital form, that is in the digital and analog in both the forms. Because you know, for preservation purposes, microfilm copies are prepared, and in National Archives of India, one positive copies, we are, and the copies we are keeping at our regional office, Bhopal. We are having actually 4 offices all over India, head office in Delhi, and in Bhopal, we are having the regional office. In Jaipur, Pondicherry, and Bhubaneswar, we are having our regional centers. So in our regional office, we are keeping the one copy of the microfilm just as part of the disaster management program. So in the preservation priorities, that is in the preservation at strategies, most important is the monitoring the environmental conditions in the storage, its processing, access, and exhibits spaces. Because records are also exhibited in any exhibition. So before sending it for display and after when we received it, then also checking of the document is very, very important. Implementation and prioritization of the preservation actions, whatever action is needed in the preservation, in the storage area, as a preventive measure, for eradication of the infestation, as a remedial measure, or as a restorative measure, we have to prioritize our program. And most important is the proper handling by both users and staff. Because staff are also handling the records, and users, if physical records are supplied. Then side by side, the monitoring and tracking of the risks threatening to all the records of all farmers, whatever farmers we are having in our custody. That is, we have to maintain the stable housing conditions to protect the records, and also to minimize the threats, all the threats to the records from food and also food drinks that, and from the waste and pollutants. In case of new acquisition, suppose when we are receiving the records from the record creating agencies, because after certain, suppose 25 years old, we are receiving is the bundle format. So first thing, what we are doing, we are not sending the records directly to the stack area, the storage area for storage. First step is the removal of dust and dirt using the compressed air, whatever dust and dirt is there, then fumigation of the records after cleaning in a vacuum fumigation chamber, good to get rid of any live insects that might be present in the records, if there is any. So it is just to ensure the removal of dust and dirt or paste as a preliminary step just before the records are shifted to the stack area. This is just our effort to make infested records should not enter inside our storage area. Then it is going to some other place for proper acquisition arrangement, that is the proper documentation work. It is not the main storage area. We have a housing area separately for the newly acquisition record. Then preventive measure, one more important thing is that not only the maintenance of the temperature and humidity or the climatic conditions, it is the monitoring and maintenance of the building, which is very, very important. If the building is faulty, or unnecessarily records may get damaged if there is any seepage or any other things. So continuous monitoring is needed, and also maintenance of the climatic conditions inside the storage area. Then good quality material, which is very, very important for both for storage and for the preservation of records. If suppose we are using the storage material, that is the file cover, if it is acidic in nature, and if we were just directly stitching the file cover to the file, then what will happen? Acidity will be transmitted to the records with the passage of time. So our records will get infested. So National Archives of India, we are having a research laboratory also as part of our preservation unit. So Conservation Research Laboratory, National Archives of India is ensuring the use of the quality materials, both for the storage and for the preservation of records. So quality checking is very, very important. And how quality checking is done? By determining the physical and chemical properties of the material before procuring it or on receipt of the stock also. So generally, some of the properties I have mentioned, that is GSM, thickness, smoothness, uniformity, wet strength, moisture content in case of all the paper materials. Then chemical properties, alpha cellulose, copper number, pH, ash content, and also accelerated aging before and after. Then physical strength of the paper, that is the folding endurance, bursting strength. And performance tests, test is suppose tissue paper, whatever the tissue we are using for tissue repair. So performance test is also carried out just to check its performance on our old records, not on the original records. Obviously, all these tests are done on the dummy document. So this is the remedial measure, means as part of the preventive conservation program, whenever we are receiving the records from the outside agencies, this is our portable fumigation vaults. If we are receiving the records in a small quantity, bulk is not much. So we are using this chamber for fumigation purposes. And this is the vacuum fumigation chamber, which is a size of 300 cubic feet. This is used. And this is the door, and the door is closed. So you can see the open bundles are kept inside. It is closed vacuum. Operation means re-strengthening the documents. So you can see the documents, which is circular in nature. Its diameter is almost 1 feet. No, more than 1 feet. It's almost 2 feet diameter. So it has written portion at the backside also. So restoration doesn't mean you have to repair each and every page with tissue. You have to repair each and every page with the handmade or whatever may be. That depends on the condition and type of the damage type of the document. So in this way, this can be done. So this is the 3-4 page sheets of documents due to acidity. It's highly 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. So it can be repaired in this way. So this can be repaired. So this is a single sheet. This is one of the letter of the Rabindranath Tagore. So this is repaired in this way. Obviously, it needs very expertise. Without the expertise, no one can do this thing, because we have to add in the letters also. Then if suppose single sheets of document, this is some currency notes we are having in our custody, so we encapsulate these documents. So this is just an example. Okay, preservation means there are restrengthening procedures are different. So different techniques can be used. So this is also one thing. Sometimes we are observing there are patches all over the documents. So some written portion are hidden there. So we remove the patches, then as part of the restoration, we repair it. Repair it using the CMC paste or gluten-free starch paste and attaching the tissue paper. So this is the Gilgit manuscripts. You know, birch bark is not affected by insects. It is only affected by the fungus only. So birch bark manuscript received at NAI in 1949, I told you earlier. So one of the documents are infested by fungus. So we only give the chemical treatment to the records. So after restoration, after repair each and each page, one more thing, okay, we are trying to open the volume after repair in a 180 degree format, because then no need to, we have to do the digitization, we have to do the microfilming, no need to remove the binding, because once we repaired, it is the final work is done. So, and the volume can be opened at 180 degree angle, because this type of, that is the sectional stitching is done. And no direct stitching all over the documental parts. Whenever needed, all the techniques are reversible. So whenever needed, we will get our documents back. So conservation program, and one more important thing before for the conservation program is the condition assessment. Once we do the condition assessment, how we are doing it? Series wise. Sometimes there is a priority. Okay, this is the priority type of documents that need by some record creator and all we have to do. So priorities are changing. So what we are doing in the condition is identification, the composition of the material, type of damage, and what steps are to be taken in the conservation steps. So fate of the document is decided. What steps, what type of repair is to be done to that document. So this is just the documentation before the conservation work is done. And conservation work is carried out as per this assessment of this document. So prioritization is done either as per the need of the user or by department wise, or on the basis of the rarity of the documents, or if suppose record creators needed the record. So, and another thing is the stabilization, and the documents are treated to prepare them for the digitization. For digitization, suppose one of the documents is found very brittle. On priority, we have to conserve the records. And for the exhibition purposes also, if one to display, generally we are not displaying much originals in the documents. Now also one exhibition, a small exhibition is in the display in our foyer, in our annex building, where we have displayed only one or two originals. That is also very less time period, and mostly are the copies. And it is how it is whenever it is needed by the researchers. So this is how the priorities of the documents and stabilization work is also taken place. So now I want to discuss one thing. In the conservation, Sanskrit and Gilgit manuscript received by NAI in the 1949 and 50. That when it received, whenever we receive one small collections, condition assessment is done first, then cleaning, then treatment if it is needed, then we are sending to the storage area for the proper documentation part before supplying it to the provided the documents to the user. So this collection received in 1950, necessary preservation measures, whatever was needed, was taken then only. But as per the periodic inspection means work is also carried out. This is also because once we are conserved, our work is not done. We have to do it periodically. So as part of this periodic inspection program, In 2012, we have again completely, besides in between also, so many times it has been done, we found some of the records are started damaging. So we conserve that, and after assessment, we segregate the manuscript as per the conservation needs. Some are in the completely good condition, some need only minor repairs, some need only the bindings. There is some problem in the binding, all the. Then we prioritize the conservation work, and after complete conservation, we keep the manuscripts in the storage boxes. That is, most of the Gilgit manuscripts actually are in the manuscript form, that is in the leaf, that is the birch bark leaves. So now the work is also not done. After that also, because that is in 12, and now it is 20, so already 8 years. So in between also, we are doing the post-conservation care and periodic examination of the documents. So conservation does not mean only the treatment to the records. Side by side in the stack area also, we have to taking care of the records. So this is the some glimpses of the conservation manuscripts. You can see this is the Gilgit manuscript. Suppose this document, only the binding was damaged, and there is another, all the pages are in a very good conditions. Only what is the problem? Pages are stuck up due to the ink and because of some glossy paper. This document is written on a very glossy paper. So we've done some interleaving work. It is a page by page interleaving with the tissue paper, because we have to use the good quality material for these purposes also. And only here the spine are damaged. So we need the corrections of the spine only. In this way, and this is also one big documents on large folio, contains around 400 folios of leaves of palm birch bark manuscripts. So in preservation program, what are the important progress? That is, we need continuous monitoring and overall management and proper disaster management measure. That is as part of the preventive conservation measure, which is very, very important. And periodic checking of the storage area, maintenance of the climatic conditions inside the storage area, and side by side, if there is growth of any insect, any problems in the building also. And different forms, suppose cartographic records, if you were having architectural drawing, that should be kept separately from the public record, that is the A4 or A3 side of records. And microfilm and electronic record storage area should also be separate. It's not inside the, because storage conditions are totally different for the paper records and for the electronic records and for the analog records also. And one more important decision it is taken, records which are already digitized or microfilm, that should not be provided to the users. And we are generally, policy decision has already been taken, so that is not provided to the user. And in any records are also available in the intranet also. I am coming into that afterwards. Another problem in the preservation documents, those who are having the documentary heritage. Lamination, that is the tissue paper and cellulose acetate foil lamination. It is one of the technique used till 1990 for lamination of all the records all over the world, not only in India, all over the world. So all the institutions are having, in National Archives of India also we are having, they must be having these documents, the already laminated records. So what are the problems? There are cockling problems. There are so many problems. Pages breaks up, most are, so many problems. And one more important problem is the vinegar syndrome. So for this, what to do? For thinking about this, we have started the condition assessment of the laminated record we are having in our custody, because it is not wise to delaminate all the records and then prepare it in some other way, because it's a very laborious process. But as in pilot work, we have started, which is part of our Sanskrit manuscript, which was laminated in the 1950s. That was repaired by the, restored by the lamination techniques. We delaminated the documents completely. That was laminated using the tissue paper and CA foil. That was done in our CRL. So this is the laminated document, and we delaminated the records completely remove the binding, or each and every page we delaminated. After delamination, we repaired the document by using the tissue paper with the gluten-free starch paste. So you can see the condition of the document, but vinegar syndrome was not much in this document, maybe because of the paper quality, which was alkaline in nature, or the paper was highly basic in nature. So, and this is the conditions. This is this we done in 2017. So these two photographs, but this is the photograph I took recently last week. So you can see the conditions. The one document we have completely delaminated, and then we repaired it, and now the document that we are maintaining the storage area properly, and we are also doing the continuous monitoring for all the records. So delamination for each and every page, is it advisable? Because it's a laborious process. We have to use the acetone to delaminate the records, which is harmful for the health of the staff also. So now what to do with the laminated record? We cannot decide, okay, we delaminate each and every records. Now it is very easy to say, okay, we are not laminating the records. We are not doing laminations. I have discussed these things with so many conservators. They are saying, yes, we have stopped laminating. Yes, we are also not doing. But what to do with all the delaminated record that we are having in our custody? And mostly the archives, they are having, or documentary heritage, those who are having in their custody, they are having the laminated records. So some important thing means what I observe, that if we store the documents in a stable environmental conditions and periodic, if we do the periodic examination and regular monitoring, means at a certain interval, we have to check the documents, and the copy should not be provided for consultation purposes. Strictly, only the digital copies for the consultations, the original should not be provided. And proper handling, those whoever is examining the record also need proper handling of the record. So this is a big problem for all the archival heritage. So in the preservation management, main is the policies. We have to define some policies. We have to assess the records. We have to prioritize the system. And another thing is the allocation of the resources to prioritize. If we have the funds and all, then we can prioritize our work. And collections should be examined more closely for improved storage and reformatting also. And emergency disaster planning, not only for the laminated records, for all the records. This is required for safety of the staff and also for the collections. And that should be reviewed and revised after every 2 years. That is proper fire safety measure, proper all the measures for the disaster. So in the preservation management and the reformatting, we are having a program for digitization and micro. I will not go into detail about the microfilming because our separate unit is looking after this. So this is required to facilitate the global access, to safeguard the original records. And for this, side by side, we have also started digitization on demand facility in our Abhilekh portal. This is our website. You will get all the links in our website. And besides, we have also started a portal, which is the abhilekhportal.in. You can consult the records after logging in, properly logging in, record series, some of the record series, and also indexes that are available. You can demand for your records. If you the records are available, you can put your demand for copies also. So copies will be supplied. There is a full process. If you just see this portal, you will come to know about all this. Another thing is, Prime Minister of India, the Netaji papers are also there, and you will see these links here. Whatever Netaji papers we are having, that is also available in the web, in this netajipapers.gov.in. So now what is needed in a preservation program? In the management of preservation program, most important is the collection management. And as part of the collection management, we have to do what? That is the environmental control. If we do the environmental control, we keep the records in a good conditions, half of the problems will be solved. Then condition assessment. Before conservation treatment, condition assessment of the records is very, very important. And then conservation treatment, which is needed as per the assessment or documentation of the conservation work of this records. Then use of quality materials for the storage, for both storage purposes or whatever materials we are using for storage and conservation purposes, reformatting and duplication, that is the preparation of the digitized copy and microfilm copy. All these things can be possible if we are doing the training program properly, if we have a trained staff. So we need a proper trained staff for all these work. Not any person can do this. You need a specialty, a special expertise in all this field. And another thing is needed, it is the conservation research. That is it's a scientific field. Continuous development is needed in this field because the records are changing. We are now in the digital phase. So this is also very, very, so these are some of the part of the program of a preservation program. And one more thing, as part of the preservation program, we need some standards. If suppose we leave some standard documents, we'll follow some standard practice. So some of the problems will be solved. Suppose these are some of the standards, one for the binding, which is IS3. These are Indian standards, and there is one ISO, which is the International Standard for Information and Documentation. It clearly mentions about the document storage conditions and disaster management measure. And this is IS3050 is about the binding of library books and periodicals. One point added in the revised edition 2015 about the rare materials and the archival records. Then this is the IS1774-1986, which is the specification of the paper of the permanent and semi-permanent records. One thing is, suppose in government, in any organization, we are creating the records on paper. Suppose if we'll use the good quality material, our records can last for longer if we maintain the storage conditions properly. Then only, and we can maintain. So in this way, we can use it. Then there is another IS2663-1989, which is the recommendation relating to the primary element in the design of buildings for archives. Whatever is needed for the building, for an archives building, what are the units, how to take care of the buildings, everything is mentioned in this standard. Same as for the libraries, as the libraries are also keeping the paper material, there is another standard is available for this library building. Another is the fire safety measure as part of the disaster management measure. This is one of the standard for the fire safety measures for archives and libraries. And this is very, very important, I can say, in case of the tropical countries, because we are having much insect problem in the tropical countries, just like India. So this is the code for practice for the anti-termite treatment in buildings, because which is very, very important as for the preventive measure or preventive conservation program. So there are some problems also. Problems are everywhere. So there are some problems in the preservation also. Lack of awareness. So by this means, sometimes records get damaged by poor training during mishandling, during storage and use, poor building maintenance. This is also another thing. And they're not doing the appropriate treatment. After proper examinations, they cannot do the appropriate treatment. So these are some of the problems. Some means very few. Suppose sometimes sellotapes, we are receiving records with sellotape. So you know sellotape, normal adhesive tape, adhesive is of not good quality. So with the passage of time, what happens to this record? It's completely and it is completely disintegrated. Same as in the case of stapler pins. If the, actually in the, as part of the records management program, one point is the removal, it is recording of the files after closing. So at this step, this is a mandatory requirement to remove all the stapler pins, all the all pins, everything. But if it is not removed, if it is left, then you can see the mark, which is a acidic oxide of iron. So in the long run, what will happen? Paper started damaging from this part. Then if the tapes are attached, and during mishandling, suppose somebody is handling the record, consulting the record, some pages are folded up. So, and as the papers are old, physical strength is not too much, is less, obviously. So you can see the tear mark, and sometimes it is completely torn towards the folding lines. So, but it is not done ki records are get damaged, so we cannot conserve the records. We can conserve the records. This is just one example. If the sellotapes are attached, we can remove the sellotape. We can fill up the missing portions, but the mark, because bleaching chemicals are not used in the paper conservation, at least in National Archives of India, we are not using. So this mark is there. This area is completely acidic. We are given the treatment. We fill up the missing portions, but this mark is there. So in the preservation management, what are the prospects? We need research and development in this field, proper training, and exchange of technology, what others are doing. That is also very, very important. And side by side, exchange of resources. Whatever resources others are having, we can consult it. So we can grow better. There should be uniform policy for the conservation of the records and collaboration between the institutions, which is also very, very important. So we can do much with this collaboration work. In the prospects, one thing is, nowadays, we need a technological competence. Conservation is one part. Nowadays, we are in the digital age. We are having one digital record, that is the converted digital records, and we are having inborn digital records. So we need completely different set of technical person to handle this type of records, because we have to manage the indexes, that we have to manage the data. So we need data DB, that is database management managers, that will be kept in the cloud. So we need proper cloud managers for all this. As along with the physical records, we have to manage the digital media also, that is the electronic records, both born digital and born digital records. So new age archive professionals should be proficient in the technological prospects. This is my view. So now what National Archives of India is doing for preservation of archival heritage, we are having a grantee in aid program, in which we are giving grants to the state bodies and to the NGOs also, an amount. There's a proper thing that everything is available on our website. We are giving grant for preservation, conservation, and digitization of the documentary heritage. Then we are imparting training also. Our School of Archival Study, National Archives of India, conducts various courses in the fields of records management, archives management, conservation, reprography. Then side by side, we are also helping the government department and other organizations for inspection of the damaged records. And also we are also imparting technical advice in all the fields of archive, that is in the records management, conservation, and reprography and digitization. We are also having a lot of publication that is also uploaded. All the non-price publications are available in our National Archives of India in the publication section, and price publications are also listed there. So we are also having a lot of publications in the field of preservation also, in the field, other field also, in the records management also, just to help the others for this. Generally, non-price publications, just to help the other institutions for preservation of their documentary heritage. It is not new program. It started since 1950s. We have started all these programs. So now, what is preservation? I am to show just one step. This is one document which is completely damaged. You can see some portions are missing. There are some small pieces. This is the front side. This is the back side. Okay. This is preserved in this way. This is the complete restoration. After restoration, this is the front side and this is the back side. After restoration, this is the proper storage. So folders also needed as per the document size and document requirements. So these types of folders are prepared for these purposes. And second is the digital copy. Preservation is over. So the digital copy, prepare the digital copy for consultation purposes and for other work also. So this is a complete process after documentation on all. So this is just glimpses of one corner of our preservation work. So thank you so much. Padma, over to Padma.
Thank you, Dr. Sutapa. Thank you very much for a very interesting talk. Please, we have a few questions. So with your permission, I'll take those.
Yes, yes.
And before I proceed to the question, I think I forgot to mention today was our 50th lecture.
Okay.
20 series. I forgot to mention that. So it's a big day for us as well. So I'll take the questions up. The very first question that we had was... Do you also conserve private records if people approach you, or it's just the national and state records?
No. We preserve private records also. We are having a complete separate unit for preserving the private records, which is name is Private Archives. Recently, we received one records. Today only, we completed the condition assessment of that document we received from the Benaras, from one of the writers. We are having Gandhi papers, Netaji papers. I think the list is available in our website. There's a complete separate setup, because as these records are totally different from the public records, so that is has been kept completely separate.
But is there a criteria for selecting these private records? Or do you have a process, or anybody can
account? Actually, private persons, they are approaching us. Just we received 2 years back, we received Gandhi paper, that is the Monu Ben collections. So Gandhi Sriti approached us because they are not capable to conserve the records. So they want to donate the records to the National Archives of India. That is, we have received the records by donation.
Okay.
So there is some clause and all.
But I think the question was, can any common man do the conservation with the archives deal with any private, any common man, can anyone walk in and consult for the...
Actually, for consultation purposes, anybody can come, but they need, there is some criteria for visiting the department.
That's what I was asking.
They should have some ID and all. And for the researchers, generally, it is open to the researchers. For a valid title is needed, letter from the their supervisor or from the university.
Okay, so there you conserve. If you conserve private records, are there any charges for the services that?
No. We are not doing private work. Whatever records we are having in our custody, that's what we are doing.
Okay.
We are not doing any private.
You take work. Private work, private records.
No. Private records. Whatever records are donated to us, that we are you have seen our bulk. So we cannot take the work of other organizations. We can give them consultation. We can advise them.
Thank you for the clarification. The next question is, how do you manage conservation? How did you manage this conservation program in the lockdown period? And what measures were taken during the lockdown?
During the lockdown period, actually, it was completely closed during April because of the complete lockdown. From May last week, we have started the work as per the government orders, means whatever the norms. Keeping in mind the social distancing measures. Suppose 20 persons are working, we are calling only the 7 or 8. So just we have to do that measure, because that cannot be done from home. We have to be present physically for conservation work. So in this way, whatever the output is less during this period, because we cannot do much. We cannot call the total 20%, because we have to follow these guidelines and you know about the COVID. Mm-hmm. But since May last week, we are doing it. And from August, I think we are... government relaxes the norms. So we have started working with the 75% attendance, person. So work also started up, speeded. And now our research room is closed till today. I don't know, it will be open maybe within some weeks. But we are receiving the request through our Avilek portal. So we have to run our conservation unit, because there are so many DOD requests in our Avilek portal.
Thank you. The next question is, owing the enormous amount of records, how is the condition audit carried out for the conserved records from time to time? Is there a policy in place for...
Actually, there is a policy. It cannot be done at 1 day or 2 day. There is a team. We are setting up the team. So sometimes they are doing this work. And our stack area in charges, who is the person who are looking after the stack areas, they are also the trained personnel. So they are also trained. Staff inside the stack areas, they are also trained. in the archives field. Tell a little bit about the conservation also. And our minimum, suppose the stitching work, that we are doing some part of the work. If suppose file is only, there is some tear in the file cover, that work is done in the stack areas only. So we have deputed staff for these purposes. So they can look after that part. If suppose if there is any damages observed in one corner of this stack area, for this stack area in charges are responsible. They immediately inform the conservation unit. So then we started the complete conservation assessment. So it is a joint effort. It is not only the work of the conservation personnel. As our all the archivist personnel, they are trained in this field.
Thank you. But I think the question more was like how is the condition assessment done? How frequently is it done on the conserved records that you have kept? You already conserved?
Yes, already conserved record we are doing. That
measures the condition.
Measures the conditions, whatever the record. Just like Sanskrit manuscript we had, on the rarity wise, we are giving the priority.
Okay,
and in case of the handwritten records, whatever handwritten records, bulk, I can say in 1 week, you can, so one person can do 100 to 200 documents, not much.
Okay.
So that depends. And during the lockdown periods, obviously the quantum decreases.
Okay. Thank you. The next question is, can we conserve all types of documents in a digital format? Or there are documents which cannot be
In case of documentary heritage, I'm not talking about other artifacts. In case of documentary heritage, I think is proper digitization is done as a proper DPI and all. And if it is, suppose whatever documents we are having in our custody, if all the records are digitized, that we have also started a program for this, in which 4.5 crore pages will be digitized within 3 years. Just to safeguard our records. So paper records can be digitized, not the, I cannot say the other artifacts, but one question is there. Suppose if we are having the cartographic records, that is the outsized documents, we need special scanner for this. So that also depends the availability of the equipment. If the A0 size or more than that size documents are not available, how you will digitize that document? So this availability should be there.
Next, thank you. The next question is there an association like Friends of the Archives linked to NAI?
I think there is one organization, and we are also having one committee, National Committee of Archivists, and one IHRC also, National Committee. All these things we are having. And earlier, actually, National Archives of India was also published one journal, Indian Archives. That have stopped last 2-3 years. And we are having bodies for the researchers, users, whatever, for the users.
So they how can one get in touch with them? That is the question. Is there any?
Actually, for these sections, our consultation unit, that is the research room unit, they are dealing with this. I'm not in direct touch with this. For this, they can write a letter to our director general or the email given in our website. They will get all the information.
Okay, thank you. What new techniques have been implemented in the conservation process? Any new techniques that NAI has recently started?
For this, I can say we have started repair of our outsized documents. Earlier, it was that means cartographic records, which is in very highly damaged conditions. Earlier, we used to attach the merkin cloth, which is very thick, for which the documents are, weight of the document increases. So then we tried into, okay, some paper, that is the handmade paper and all. But after attaching the handmade paper, we have seen that documents are very dry, or it is crumble type after repair. So we removed that part also. Now we have started recently one very fine cloth. Fine cloth for repair of the outsized map, because maps we are not encapsulating. Because in the encapsulations, if we're just attaching very fine cloth, actually last to last week only we have started this job. And document is very flexible. We are using the gluten-free starch, thick starch for attaching this cloth on the back, because sometimes we are having large map inside the file. Suppose in a file of pages, 50 pages file, we are having very long, large size map, which has to be folded. So if suppose we are repairing it in paper when we are folding it, so there's a, that creates much problem. So we have started this, so it is in the, under observation now. I can't say anything because the
The next question is, what chemicals are permissible to be used for the fumigation of records? You showed that large chamber. What chemicals?
Actually, in the fumigation chamber, that was installed in NEI in the 1950. But it is in a still working condition. Now, in the process of procuring another one, but we need a space for installation of this. Earlier, ethylene oxide and, you know, the ethoxide gas was used in this chamber. But ethylene chloride, that has stopped. We are not using. We are only creating the vacuum nowadays inside the chamber. Mm-hmm. And sometimes if the documents are highly damaged, then we are trying to incorporate very less percentage of carbon dioxide gas. Otherwise, only in vacuum, we are trying to do the fumigation.
Okay. Thank you. The next question is, what are the benefits of tissue repair and the longevity of this technique?
Tissue repair, if suppose we do it properly, after proper washing, that is, whatever the acidity, if we're not doing that, I'm not talking about acidity. Nowadays, there is a question in acidity also, because in high alkalinity, cellulose, there is a polymerization effect of cellulose also. So if suppose just you wash the paper, there is a problem of sizing is removed. That is also one question. So after washing, if just you apply the CMC paste and attach the tissue paper, record can last for very longer time period, provided you keep the records properly. That is, you are maintaining the storage condition. That is, after repair, main problem is the storage area. If you store the documents properly, it can last for the longer time period. If you are not storing or keeping the records properly inside the stack, obviously it will not last for the longer time. Then you cannot question the tissue repair. Okay, documents get damaged because of tissue. Because yes, there is some other reason.
Thank you. The next question is, the highest standards and the different standards that you've shown in that slide. Are these available online? Can one?
No, this is all the publications are prized publications. So you can get it from the Bureau of Indian Standard Office, National, in Manak Bhavan, New Delhi. Okay. I think it may be available online also. You can go to their website. All are prized publications.
So it's the
maybe older edition. It is a Bureau of Indian Standard and yes. National Archives of India, in collaboration with them, they just formulated the standards.
We do have one question, though I don't know whether it's directly related to the talk from Mr. Indrajit Bhattacharji. He says he has a late 19th century card collection, which is from his grandfather. The album is completely out of shape, but he feels the cards are still in good shape. So what can you suggest for its preservation? I think one...
Please repeat the question. There is some problem.
He has a late 19th...
There is some problem.
Sorry? Hello, can you hear me now?
Oh. I can't hear. Please repeat.
Yeah. He says he has a late 19th century...
What is the problem? I don't know.
Maybe you muted. I think if you can see...
Late
19th century cigarette card collection that got from his grandfather. The album is completely out of shape, but the cards are still in good condition, with some showing loss.
Okay.
What can be done? I think once you have a look at it, only then you can. I think.
Yes. Yes. First, I have to examine it. And one more thing, if he wants to donate, he can donate it to the National Archives of India. So we can look it up.
Yeah, then you can.
That is also another option.
That's a very, very interesting answer. I think the most apt answer. So yes, please be.
No, otherwise, he is in Delhi only. He is in Delhi.
I don't know, Indrajit Bhattacharji.
If he is in Delhi.
I'm in Jaipur, ma'am.
Yeah, Indrajit, it's a private collection. Bring it to Intact.
Sure, ma'am. Sure. I am from Jaipur, ma'am.
Okay. So yeah, if you donate,
okay, we're from
donated, the National Archives okay. will take it up. Otherwise, you can always get it to him. We'll have a look at it.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
You can donate it.
I know. No. If he donates it, I have no issue. Let him donate it.
Yeah. That's Intact also. Okay.
So I think those are the questions. Thank you everyone for joining us. Thank you, Dr. Sutapa Chakravarti. I think we had a wonderful session today.
Okay, thank you.
All the best to the National Archives of India Department for doing such a great work.
Thank you, sir.
Huge call looking at these archives. I'm sure the numbers themselves speak for the task in hand. Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for joining us. See you.
Thank you, Padma, for giving me the opportunity to discuss about this, whatever we are doing at National Archives.
Thank you.
And I request you to visit once National Archives of India.
Definitely. It's been a while, but I'll definitely be there. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Everyone.